Hello everyone, how are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. Hope everyone's doing well. We're getting ready to do a Scorpio love reading. So let's see what we have for you here. We have blossoming Scorpio. What is going on? I like it. The energy of growth. We have masculine. Ooh, sexy. I love a bare chest, right? We have extremes, the hot moon. So we have, it's hot in the old town tonight. We also have darkness. So Scorpio, we will clarify everything. So let's look and see what the bottom of the deck energy is for our beautiful Scorpio friends before we jump into this reading, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Also, too, if you do like the video, YouTube is very picky. They won't really show the video to any other people or very many unless you show likes and comments. And so I always appreciate it when you do that. All right, the Two of Swords. So, Scorpio, who are you not speaking to? What's going on here? We're going to find out for you. So in the recent past, new love, Scorpio. This is a mutual energy between you and your person right there. Ace of Cups, new beginnings and love. The current mutual energy between you and your beloved is honey, I'm home, Cancerian energy, water energy, Libra energy. But that is the Emperor is driving the chariot into the future. I love it. What we see your person is thinking about the situation. Oh, the fire to go the distance. Leo energy, the infinity symbol, number 8. The strength card, the courage, the fortitude, the desire, the strength to really enjoy. Your person wants a relationship with you. They see you as the one. All right, how they view you. Somebody who's invested, somebody who's very patient. This is Taurus energy. It's the energy of you sort of just being very, very much the energy of just taking everything a day at a time, investing without getting overly invested. Your person is, Ace of Wands. A new passionate beginning is how they're feeling. So this is looks like a new relationship for most of you with all this heat. All this, you know, Ace of Cups, Ace of Wands energy. How they view the situation or relationship unfolding. Nine of Swords. There is something that is haunting them. Nine of Swords energy. Remorse, regret. Something about the past is getting in their way. The Nine of Swords is losing sleep at night, feeling like they need to apologize. And I was taking that from the wrong deck. These are my clarifiers, but we'll just reverse the process and clarify with the Light Seer's Tarot. All right, your person is, what's hidden between the two of you? Leo energy again, strong Leo presence here. Your person really, the two of you have fire in your belly. You want this commitment. You have, that's a big major arcana energy. This is a very significant relationship and it speaks to the fact that the fire, the passion, the enjoyment, of this relationship is profound for both of you. We have the Seven of Cups. Spirit is saying don't make a decision yet. The advice of Spirit is that there's a lot you don't know, Scorpio, and you should take your time. That's your energy. The Seven of Cups is Scorpio energy. That you can get burned here. If you make the wrong choice with this person, you could find yourself in some hot water. What is the short-term outcome at this time? Nice, the Hierophant energy. Making a commitment, dating exclusively, building a foundation, a future, moving into Taurus energy. That's your seventh house of marriage on the astrology wheel. It is a powerful energy. It's Venus, it's the moon. It's really gravitating towards one another because of the just the intrinsic attraction between the two of you. Very powerful. So let's see here what we have for your clarifiers. So we see a new, passionate, fabulous beginning, but your person has something that it looks like they could be holding back, and they're very worried about it. They're losing some sleep over the path forward here. The Six of Coins, both of you are invested in the relationship and you are not talking about it. So it is the energy of like, okay, I don't really know what's going on. But there's things you don't know yet. You are not seeing the whole picture, and that's why Spirit is saying, you know, don't make any choices yet. And we see this worry on the part of your person that would merit being very careful right now. Okay, so what do we have? Why else do we have the Two of Swords here? Oh, you are manifesting one another. Beautiful energy. I like it. The Empress. It's all about love. Taurus energy again. Very strong attraction here for you. So you're in this energy of going to the next level with this person. Look at that, the Universe card. This person could be very different from you. They could be from a different ethnicity, a different culture, a different country, a different way of looking or viewing the world. The Judgment card, you, the two of you are making the decision to jump in. Now, when we get the Judgment card, it can be karma revisited. It can be someone coming back from the past, because with the butterfly energy, it's a rebirth. It's very much Scorpio energy. So it may be a rebirth in love. The Hierophant energy is telling us once again, a very traditional, tried and true, committed relationship is developing. The Six of Swords is moving forward after a time of trouble, after a time of difficulty. Yeah, swimming away, going across in that boat, across the water to calmer times, leaving burdens behind. You know, it's oftentimes an act of forgiveness. So what do we have here for the Chariot? Ooh, the Emperor is driving that chariot. So the masculine energy in this relationship is powerful. The masculine energy really wants to say, honey, I'm home, to drive into the future. But the Five of Swords is a bit of a warning here, my friends. A bit of a warning. That Five of Swords energy is mutually, it could be some mind games going on between the two of you. Might be playing hard to get, but it's not being true to your inner core of your true self. We have, in your desire to have a new beginning, the Five of Swords can also indicate past wounds, because we have the Five of Swords here as a wound and the Six of Swords here as healing that wound. But the wound is there and it needs to be addressed to have that new beginning, to throw caution to the winds. Here we have the Lover's card, Gemini energy, lovely, lovely energy. Soulmate energy, your ability to talk through the problems, to discuss anything is tremendous. We see those beautiful, beautiful bald eagles there really chatting with each other. The Strength card, how your person sees the path forward with you, is very powerful. Four of Swords yet again. So we have the Four, Five, and Six of Swords. Healing energy, your person knows that they have to make amends for something. They were dishonest, but again, I have to tell you, we have a lot of swords here. We have the Four of Swords, the Five of Swords, the Six of Swords, the Seven of Swords now, and the Nine of Swords. So it really is, there's a lot of discussion that has to go on in this relationship with all of those swords. That Seven of Swords energy is your person wants you back, even if they have to be dishonest or not really tell you the whole truth and nothing but the truth. They're in it to win it at all costs. But Five of Coins, they may have left you in the cold in the past, and they may come back and give you the story they think you want to hear to win you back. Now, the love is real, so I don't want to diminish that, but that kind of energy of not being honest or straightforward is something that looks as though it caused a rift in the past, and it may in the future if you're not careful, which is why Spirit is saying Seven of Cups. Be careful. Don't commit too early. Don't make a decision yet. Seven of Cups. Seven of Cups is repeating itself. So it does look like you should not have your head in the clouds. Have the strength to really look at this you know, to allow the blossoming, to understand that there is darkness in this relationship, even though we have all of this absolute extreme heat, masculine energy, and blossoming, there's a dark side of the moon here that has to be addressed for the two of you to have success here. The Magician card, again, that your person sees you as magical, Scorpio. Look at that. They just see you as absolutely magical. That is the energy of Virgo, of Gemini, of talking through things. They feel as though you are a magician, that you can manifest anything that you want. That's how they view you. I love that eye. The Three of Swords. Okay. So now I think we have all of the swords here. We have Two of Swords, Three of Swords, Four of Swords, Five of Swords, Six of Swords, Seven of Swords, Nine of Swords. So we have all of the minor arcana swords with the exception of the Eight of Swords, self-imposed restriction. So right now it looks as though they may have lied to you, they may have cheated on you in the past, they may have put you in a third party situation, they may even come back to you before they're completely free. But you have a very powerful life path together. Whether you choose it for the future or not is going to be up to you, free will. So let's see here what we have. We have the Ace of Wands, Three of Coins. They want to collaborate with you. They want to work through the issues. They want to prove to you that they're worthy of your time, of your energy. Spirit of Wands is a King of Wands energy. King of Wands energy here is twice. So there's something that's very robust. We have three Leos here, three Leo energies here. So it does look like the two of you together are very dynamic. You have a lot of power of creativity. The Strength card twice, here and here. Again, profound Leo energy. You might be dealing with the Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. This person has fire in their belly. The Two of Swords, though, right now we see them so worried that they're not taking action. Two of Swords twice. So there's a lot. When we see the swords, we see painful truth. And the painful truth is that this person wasn't always, I don't think they were very honest with you. I think that they have a proclivity for, you know, saying the easy thing, taking the easy way out, telling you what you want to hear. I don't think they're mean-spirited, okay? I don't think they're mean-spirited, but I think this person is really a lightweight in terms of being able to deal with the reality of things. We have the Movement of Cups. We do have the Romantic Knight of Cups. He can be flaky. He can tell you that he's madly in love with you and then sort of drift off. You know, forget they have dinner date the next night. I love the Knight of Cups. He's very much, you know, a powerful love energy. But again, the Prodigal Son, the Ten of Swords. There we go. There's the nine to the ten. But they want a new beginning with you. Ace of Coins are coming in with a substantial offer. They have fire in their belly. They want to do the work. So they're coming in with what appears to be an apology. It looks as though they're going to come in with an apology. It looks as though they're going to try to win you back. The Death card, Scorpio energy, to rebirth the relationship. You know, you're going to have to go through a period of reconciliation, the butterfly. So I do think that this is I very much think this is a reconciling of an old relationship. Somebody that disappeared, somebody that went off and left you in the cold, I feel. And we see the Wheel of Fortune. Good. Sagittarius energy, the Wheel of Fortune is turning in your favor. Very favorable energy. It's Jupiter. It's good luck. It's expansion. The Tower card. Okay, so Spirit is telling you that this person's going to reveal something that you never knew before. The Tower card is the epiphany. It's the shock. It's the awe of something that is unpleasant. They're going to tell you that they're going to express their feelings about loving you. The Four of Wands, how much they want a foundation with you. The Four of Coins, they've really never let go of you energetically. You might have felt that energy pull. The Three of Wands. As far as they're concerned, you are their person. Now, whether you're going to have to be careful because Spirit is absolutely telling you you need to be careful. Seven of Cups. So Scorpio, you guys are the, you know, very powerful creators, so you'll do. Okay, so what we see here is you may not reconcile or agree to marriage. I'm getting the Temperance reversed. So you may, you know, if this person's married and approaching you, I think that you're just going to say no. And, you know, it doesn't look like you would have an affair with them. It looks as though you would consider reconciling, though, if for, this is only going to be for a few, for those who are having the return of a soulmate lover who is married, went off maybe and married someone else instead of you, you will not accept this person back until they are single. You're happy to have them as a friend, to see them in group situations. You may have a group of friends that you share. The Ace of Coins or the Page of Coins is, you know, a small offer that you would accept from them. The Two of Coins says that you really are not going to give them a serious, any kind. You're going to juggle them with other people. You're going to date other people. You're going to leave it up to them to figure out what they want to do. The Ten of Coins does say that a legacy relationship may be in store for you, that it's very likely if you can work through the problems. But this is not a, this is a very, very, very Scorpionic reading because it's very challenging. It requires death and rebirth. A lot of Scorpio energy here for you. What is the blossoming about, Spirit? What is this card about? Okay, let's see. We have the Mother of Cups, Queen of Cups. So there is a lot of love here. There's a desire to nurture each other. There's a desire to protect each other. Well, tell us about the masculine, please. Four of Coins. You know, holding on, holding back. Somebody who doesn't really give their all. The Six of Wands, they want a win, though, with you. You know, winner, winner, chicken dinner. But again, that's a victory. On the dark side of the moon, that can be a notch in the belt, but I don't see that being the case with you. They simply want to have a victory in love with you. And we get the Daughter of Wands. So there is, this person is, has a tendency to almost be like a little kid in their approach. You know, that Daughter of Wands is a Page of Wands. So they're very enthusiastic. But here we have Wheel of Fortune yet again. So when the timing is right, this person will come forward and confess the extremes of what has happened in your relationship. Chariot card, honey, I'm home again. Tell us about the darkness, please, for our Scorpio friends. The Nine of Coins. So they do see you as very highly desirable. They feel as though you don't need them and you may not want them based on what they did in the past. And well, they might be right about that. Spirit is certainly warning you. So Scorpio, you guys are, you know, quite deep and obviously you can make great decisions. So wishing you well. Sending you love from Chicago since I'm back. Tell me where you're from and I hope to see you again in another reading. Thanks so much for joining me today. Bye-bye.